He will guard you all against the other wolves and the brigands and the murderers who are always after you. Don't you worry. He will earn his bread all right. Come on, so please, wolf, come forward. Here, peasant, please. Please, allow me to introduce wolf. This is the peasant. Peasant, this is the wolf. Aren't you shaking hands? No? There is no need of this ritual? All right, fair enough. Off you go then. They form a procession. The wolf in the middle, the peasant, the shepherd, the women, the children, all right behind him, all walking at the same pace. And as they were walking away, Francis announced, like, hey, you, watch out, be careful. Don't tread on his toes, because for nothing it will savage you. Now, very well. This wolf matter, it is settled. Now let's go up to the quarry in Stropiano together. Is it clear? You understand all the words
yes.
I'm saying?
Yes.
Because you're so silent.
We're enjoying
it. You are?
Yes.
It doesn't look like.
Yes.
It's a comic play, you know. I mean, you can laugh as well. Don't be too much attention because you will lose the best. Relax, it's just theater. Let's go to the quarry, Stropiano, to get our stone. So Francis and his brothers walks up to the quarry in Stropiano. As soon they arrive there, the quarryman who digs out the marble slabs immediately recognize Francis. They know that he is a laborer and they greet him. Hey Francis, how nice to see you. Such a long time we have not seen you. Francis, come in, sit down. Hey Francis, we have heard that you just been repairing churches. How is it going? It's going all right, thank you. It's going very well. By the way, is this the reason that I came over here? Because I ran out of stones. I need 3-4 carfuls to take. Well, I'm sorry, Francis. I'm sorry, but we cannot give out stones, marbles, labs anymore. Well, why not? What has happened? Isn't this the cave belongs to the municipality? Oh, yes, Francis. It did belong to. What has happened then? Oh, Francis, I'll have to explain. You see, you know what's happened. The monks who lives in the Civitella nearby, the Celestian monks, you know, they have an earthquake and their monastery collapsed down, half of the monastery. So what they did, they went down to the Pope in Rome and asked the Pope, Holy Father, a side wall of our monastery collapsed. Can you please allow us to take away stones, marble slabs from the Stropiano quarry? Fair enough, said the Pope. If it's only for a month, I'll give you the privilege. Okay, fair enough. Thank you so much, Holy Father. On the way back, the Pope in Rome died, and the monks went around saying, the quarry is ours! The Pope gave us the privilege for good! Damn. Francis was raging with anger. Dudas, that cannot be. This cannot be. I want to go and speak to those monks. Francis started off with his brothers again, trying to stop him, trying to hold him back. Francis, stop it. What's the matter with you? Don't be so eager, Francis. Be careful, Francis. These monks are pretty cocky. And when they see you arriving looking like a beggar, you will see. Don't, Francis, please. What's got into your mind? Don't be so crazy. This morning you strip off naked in the church, then you embrace lepers, then you talk to wolves. Now you want to talk to the monks. Be careful, Francis. They have such a terrific beast. Dogs. Dogs against me who talk to wolves. Listen, brother, I do understand. Brother. You don't need to come with me. You don't need to accompany me, you can stay here, wait for me here, I'll join you in the morning. And Francis starts off, goes up to the mountain, goes down into a valley, crosses a little river, arrives there in front of this huge monastery, looks up, Father Guardian! Father Guardian! Out of the tallest window of the monastery comes the chief of the guard. Who is he? Who's calling at this time of the night? Who's shouting? It's me, Father Guardian! I am Francis, I know what you need, ragged as you are looking for food. Sorry, it's too late. No bread left, come back tomorrow morning. No, please, I do not want any food. I need stones. Stones?
If you come at this time of the night to take the peace out of me, get out from here, otherwise I'll give you the stones, but all on your head. No, please, let me in. Please, let me speak to the chief of the monks. Let me speak to the prior. Please, get out. Please, Francis pushes the little postella. He enters into the quadri portico, walks straight by the prior.